North Daytona, led wire to wire. Let's see if that's a confidence booster for him and if he can carry that on here. Possibly a heat win, main event win here in Indianapolis.
Kato's trying to grab his breath real quick.
That was a long transfer from the floor to here.
Are you going to do the whole show in your riding gear, boots and all?
I might. It feels good. Feels good.
There he is. On Marvin.
Jimmy Dakotas on the inside, 77 here. Martin, he had a career best last week also, so a lot of competition here. This 250 East. 30-second board is up, getting ready to go.
And a long start straight here, Kevin. One of the longest we've had this year, a good 80-plus yards.
That gives you a good advantage if you don't get a good drive off the gate or a good reaction time to try to weave your way through and make something happen. If you're next to a guy that doesn't get a good jump, you want to pick them off.
Puddling into that first corner. Fight their way around the turn. Dakotas gets the whole shot, but Mushkin is right there. Bar to bar through this rhythm section. Mushkin with a slight edge. He's on the 25. Thompson is right there as well in third. Martin is behind him in fourth.
Gotta look how primed the track is right now, right? By the end of this heat race, gonna have a couple of those little reps in the turns, some of the lines through in. Track is in great shape right now.
Yeah, some of the tracks in previous rounds, they had to work in where the track got a little bit better by some of the second heats and the big bikes, 450s, which we'll be seeing here in a sec. I think this track, the best lap you're gonna see it right now, because this thing's gonna run up really quick.
Top nine, remember, goes straight to the main.
How about that? Good start there for 48 Thompson. He's in that yellow and black gear. Setting third right now. Dakotas, he's a rider in second there, the orange gear. He's been on fire lately. He's been scrappy, too. He's out of the northeast there, Massachusetts area. You can tell his fitness and his riding is where it needs to be this season. It's the best he's ever been.
One I like, Jeff, is that rider right there, the 77 on that blue Yamaha Mark. He has really been riding well, and kind of falls about what a coulda, shoulda category, what might have happened if he had made that first round.
Yeah, he struggled in the opening round, didn't make the main event, but that was his very first shooting cross of his career. But since then, he has really showed us that probably the most important thing that's really stood out about Jeremy Martin here is he goes to the inside, no, back to the outside, his fitness. He trains down there at the Carmichael Farm. Ricky said this kid works his butt off, and he definitely is, building his confidence and getting better with each and every race that he gains experience.
He does look good, and he's trending the right way. I mean, the first race, there's so many jitters that can go on your first Supercross race. It's amazing.
Well, he tried to get right inside of Thompson there. Thompson holds on to third. That's the position we're fighting for right here between the 48 and the 77.
Well, and of course, like Jeff was talking about, that opening round was in Dallas, and that track, the surface was very unforgiving. Here tonight, this is a track where you can really let it flow. You can really get your mojo working.
That guy that's training down in Florida, he can get a good taste of Dallas. Three Dallas round, that track is definitely unique to itself. Even the West Coast round, as he goes to the pass here, nice little block.
Makes the move, but then Thompson gets a better drive and regains the position by the next turn.
Dakota's right now. Thompson.
Here comes Martin. He's going to try it again. Looking for the outside. Look at how Thompson goes wide with Martin. His position.
Yeah, these two riders have really been impressive. And then just behind them is Kyle Peters. It's a good group of talent right now. And it's interesting, I think these guys now, they've got, we're basically at the halfway point for this 250 East, the fifth race for them. You're really starting to see that these guys have things dialed in. We're really seeing what they can do.
Martin squared it off beautifully, carried a lot of speed to the next corner, and takes over the position. So he'll go to third as we are just two laps remaining in this one. Right now, the final position, the transfer spot goes to Vincent on the 87, about a lap and a half to go. This is by far the best battle on the track.
tell you what, Dakotas can hold his own, but he was appreciative of that battle those guys were going through. Gave him a little bit of time as we go up to Marvin, who's, man, looking good, starting out of race here in India with the heat. Oh, all three, you see that?
Yeah, and a solid 4 second lead over Dakotas.
Yeah, look what that win can do for you, right? Chris Gann was qualifying fast in the early round. Starts weren't there, really couldn't put the pieces of the puzzle together. Now he's got the win under his belt, first win of his career. Confidence is there. This is the style of track that I think Marvin Bruce Gann can really excel on.
I think you're right. You know, we saw it with Will Hahn. I mean, he didn't win for some time. And then all of a sudden starts stringing them together. So, Jeff, what's better than one win? Two. He's looking pretty strong right now.
Yeah, yeah. Bruce Gann with the first career win a week ago in the main event, on his way now to his first heat race win of 2013.
Looking at the lap times there, his fastest is a 15.24. That's the fastest of anyone out there on the track. That's why he has that 6 second lead.
This overhead shot coming from the roof here at Lucas Oil Stadium. Checkered flag, Marvin Bruce Gann with the win. Here's the battle for the transfer. Eight. On that 67 is an 8. Vincent is in 9. He's on the 87. And it's going to go Fade, Herline, and Vincent. Those will be the last three going through straight to the main.
Pretty good ride there. Roger DeCoster and everybody at Red Bull KTM definitely have to be pleased that, like Kevin said, the momentum, everything's going in the right direction here for the French rider.
Marvin will make his way around to the podium. We'll have a chance to chat with him there. While we wait for him, let's check in with Aaron.
Thanks, you guys. For the first time this season, Davey Millsap shows up to race without that red plate. Davey, not to bring it up, but you're coming off your worst finish of the season last weekend with a 10th place in Daytona. What damage control needs to be done in order to recapture that points lead?
Well, you know, just basically the same thing I've been doing all season. Just ride like myself, you know, worry about myself and not worry about the color of my background. You know, I came into Anaheim more with a white background and left with the red. So maybe if you can pull it off tonight, you know, all that matters is if I have it at Vegas or not.
Good luck tonight. Davey Millsap, he finished up third here last year, qualifying fifth overall today in practice.
He's still got that knee that's bothering him as well. We'll see if he can ride through that. So Oldenburg is going to be the first guy to come out of this group that's going to go to the LCQ. Jeremy Martin takes a Honda into the top.